Normally, I think when we started thinking about this issue about youth work and non-formal education in this project of 12 years ago, immediate question is recognition from whom? From whom do you need recognition? And the question is, what kind of recognition do you want? Nowadays, in Europe, when you speak about recognition of non-formal learning or youth work, we speak about four different types of recognition. And that's what I would like to do maybe in the beginning, to make things a bit more complex, and then we can see what are the concrete ways, what are the examples of tools. So, when we speak about recognition nowadays, we speak about four different terms. The first one is self-recognition. Self-recognition means a recognition by yourself. This could mean, for example, when you learn something new, that you're aware of what you learned, that actually you yourself, you're aware of the value of learning, you're aware of the value of what you've learned, what you've gained, new skills, new knowledge. But it could also mean, so it could be for individual, like, and sometimes it's called individual recognition when you think about the individual person, but it could be also self-recognition, for example, from youth workers, not as a single not as a single youth worker, but let's say from youth work as a field, being aware of the value of youth work as such. So, for example, very often, actually not very often, but there's a tendency sometimes that youth workers put themselves a little bit down in relation to other sectors, saying, okay, this is not education, this is not exactly education, it's not real education. We do something, but it's not real education. So in a way, sometimes we are too modest, sometimes. And I think it's also important that actually you are aware of the value of the work you have. Another thing would be social recognition. And social recognition is awareness of others. Awareness of others, of people who are either close to what you do, let's say, for example, parents of young people that you work with, or other institutions like maybe schools in your community, or just people around, that actually they know that youth work exists, but not that they just know, but they're also aware of the value. And in a way, nobody questions that. In a way, youth work, everybody would know what youth work means. And not just that, but they would also have a positive value of that. And they would gladly send their kids to youth work events. For example, this youth center, nobody would kind of question that. If there is social recognition. If there is no social recognition, normally people don't know. Or have even negative attitude about it. Or say, well, this is something strange, you know, there's some kind of suspicion about that. So social recognition means actually having a positive regard, positive value.
And there are two more.
One is called formal recognition. And very often, when we started speaking about recognition of youth work in non-formal learning, we ended up in this category. We ended up here. Because immediately people imagine things like certificates, certification, accreditation, quality labels, these kind of stamps. So this is somehow having some kind of official procedures, kind of formal procedures, that give some kind of formal value. For example, when you have your skills developed, and it's not just value for yourself, or maybe for your surroundings, but this would be also mean that actually your skills, you gain some kind of official value for them. Like, for example, you get new qualification. So, for example, based on your 10 youth in action projects, you get a qualification of being a project manager, official in your country, for example. That would be an example of formal recognition. And there's last one, maybe not least, political. And political goes beyond the political parties and daily politics, but it's more on that something we're talking about, for example, future, is put on the agenda. So basically, the government, for example, is speaking about it. That there are laws, there are regulations, there are policies about it. And as I would say, positively thinking, no, not negatively, thinking positively, but put higher on the political agenda. So if there are any laws about youth work or any policies that support youth work, and of course, in relation to that, you also have a financial thing. Yeah? So usually, normally, if you have policies and laws, normally some kind of more kind of investments should follow. It's not always the case. But this is a political recognition. So basically, the decision makers will also see youth work or see non-formal education as a positive thing, and they are kind of discussed on the government level. These are hard. So this is a little bit of complexity of the story. And these things are not, how to say, not separated. So very often, if you analyze one thing, you can realize that it tackles several dimensions at the same time. And you can also, when you think about getting better recognition of something, you can also think about working in several quadrants at the same time.